Hi guys, so in this video we are going to talk about the shrink wrap deformer. So just like any other deformer, I come to create and select our shrink wrap deformer. That's where you choose it from. I can delete it. So what the shrink wrap deformer does is it actually helps you to project or shrink wrap one object onto another, like to take the shape of another object. And I'll go ahead to demonstrate. I'll create a cube. Increase the segment a bit, so I'll make it 50 by 50 because there should be enough segment depending on the object or the target object you want to wrap around. Then I'll come into the deformer menu here and I'll create my shrink wrap, make it a child of the cube just like any other deformer. All right, so now I want to shrink wrap the cube around an object, so I'll come in here and I'll choose, let's say, a platonic. All right, now we have to tell the cube or the shrink wrap which object you want to project or shrink wrap the cube around. So come to target object and we will choose the platonic, and you can see something happens, but it's not properly wrapping around the platonic. So let me go ahead and hide the platonic so that everything that we see is what the cube is happening. So we will actually use the scale to scale it to see what we get. So see, scale it a bit. Now it's wrapping around the platonic very well. I'll change the view to Gaussian shading and it feels like it's the platonic itself. Another thing is we can also use, let me actually go ahead and bring in a sphere, and now the shrink wrap, let's change the target to a sphere, hide the sphere itself. And you can see the cube is trying to wrap around the sphere perfectly. But one thing you have to take notice, I mean, the shrink wrap object needs to be measured in the kind of object you want to shrink wrap your source object to. So for instance, I can't come in here and create, let's say, a tube knowing that perfectly like the shape is completely different from the cube, right? And try to shrink wrap the cube around the tube. But let's try it and see how it goes. So I'll select the shrink wrap object and I'll drag in the tube. And let's go ahead and hide the tube from the view. And can see it tries its best to work, but it will be difficult for it because the hole and everything, the shapes are two completely different shapes. So it will be difficult for that to work. You can come in here, the modes, you have target axis and you have source axis, but typically the align normals is the default. Basically, there's not much. This is the strength. So let's actually go back to the sphere to see. And if you reduce, you can smoothly transform back into the cube. So you can use it to animate some sort of morphing from cube to a sphere. So with this setup, I have a tube and a torus, and because they have similar looking shape, it's easy for the tube, and the tube is shrink wrapping around the torus. So if I should hide the torus and everything, you know, the cube, and I have a linear field which is actually transitioning from the right to left, so the tube is easily and comfortably wrap around the torus with a bit of jiggle deformer, and I've animated it. It gives it a smooth transition from the tube into torus. And so you have to be proportionate and look at the kind of shape you are wrapping your object around to make sure it matches. All right, thanks, and see you in the next one.